Let's give Ben a chance for some extra credit, shall we? We're going to call this the game show host problem, all right?
Ben, suppose you're on a game show, and you are given a chance to choose from three different doors, all right? Now, behind one of the doors is a new car. Behind the other two, goats. Which door would you choose, Ben?
Door number one.
Door number one. Ben chooses door number one. All right, now, the game show host, who, by the way, knows what's behind all the other doors, decides to open another door. Let's say he chooses door number three, behind which sits a goat. Now, Ben, game show host comes up to you and says, Ben, do you want to stay with door number one or go with door number two? Now, is it in your interest to switch your choice?
Yeah.
Well, wait. Remember, the host knows where the car is. So how do you know he's not playing a trick on you, trying to use reverse psychology to get you to pick a goat?
Well, I wouldn't really care. I mean, my answer's based on statistics, based on variable change.
Variable change? But he just asked you a simple question.
Yeah, but you changed everything.
Enlighten us.
Well, when I was originally asked to choose a door, I had a 33.3% chance of choosing right. But after he opens one of the doors and then reoffers me the choice, it's now 66.7% if I choose to switch. So, yeah, I'll take door number two, and thank you for the extra 33.3%.
Exactly. People, remember, if you don't know which door to open, always account for variable change. Now, see, most people wouldn't take the switch out of paranoia, fear, emotions. But Mr. Campbell, he kept emotions aside and let simple math get his ass into a brand new car. Which is better than that goat you've been driving around campus. All right, everybody. That's the end of the day. Thank you very much.
It's time for the game of Goat Car, Goat Car! The rules are simple. There are three doors. The contestant will choose a door, and only one will lead to a brand new spanking car! But there is a twist. The other two doors will contain a goat. Therefore, the contestant who stays with the initial choice wins only one out of the three of these equally likely possibilities. Alright, contestant, we have three doors. Which one will you choose? I choose door number two. And behind door number one is the brand new car. Woo! The following tree diagram shows three possible arrangements. One of a car and two goats behind three doors. The probability of winning by staying with the initial choice is therefore 1/3, while the probability of winning by switching is 2/3. Simply put, if the contestant picks a goat, they will win a car by switching as the other goat can no longer be picked. If the contestant picks a car, they will not win the car by switching. So if you switch, you win the car if you originally pick the goat, and you won't if you pick the car. As you have 2 in 3 chance of originally picking a goat, you have a 2 in 3 chance of winning by switching.